the motto of the language teaching in the school is Binal Mal Murugu, which is learn together, and it's about Indigenous and non-Indigenous learning the language together.
I'm Sharon Case. I'm the head of teaching and learning at Mossman State School. We have 244 students. 50% of those students identify as Indigenous. We've got a range of kids from all different backgrounds.
We're going to go Big Creek. Ngayo. Ngayo. Wawubajinga.
Wawubajinga.
Dungay.
Good.
My role in the beginning was very much in the background. The whole school in the beginning was in the background. So this whole process started with a very authentic community consultation process, which took about 18 months. And in that time, we talked to community about what they wanted, how they felt about teaching their language in our school. It wasn't our language to teach, but our school is on Gugyalangi land. We have Gugyalangi kids, we have Gugyalangi families, so we thought it was really important to have Gugyalangi taught at our school.
My name is Bennett Walker. My Bama name is Garanba. My parents were Norman Walker, they called him Jungiba. My mother was Wilma Walker, they called her Nadi Jina. When the school wanted to, talking about having our language in the school, well, we said, well, we were going to have it down here, but that's a good idea. If we can start this off, you know, get it started at the schools. That's where it is now with the language. And my family, every one of them, are involved somehow. I've got one, the youngest one, with the language, doing the language at the school now with the kids. So, you know, maybe when they've trained up enough people to do teaching at the schools, then I want to get one back here. He can start doing it here with the older generation.
Yuri Yalada, Negaburi Garanba, Ne Gugyalangi Bama, Ne Borowara, Julewara, Gubriwara Bama. Hello everyone, my name is Juan Walker. I'm a Gugyalangi man from the Mossman, Daintree and China Camp areas. Our language has been introduced into the school as a great way to break down misinterpretations of local Aboriginal people and any sort of stereotypes that might have had about our people. It's a really good thing, I think, and a lot of the community as well, because for many years our people weren't allowed to speak language in the streets, you know, in my father's time and my grandparents' time.
Maidenji, Baburanji, Jilaman, Gadang.
But as going to school in Daintree, we weren't allowed to speak our language and all that. But it was so hard not to speak a language in the Daintree school at them time.
It's good for the Indigenous kids too, you know, white kids, yeah. Mm. Apart from the Aboriginal kids, you know. They're all learning together anyway. Mm. Some of the Indigenous kids, they don't know the language. Even my own kids. I talk language to them, they can't understand. But they have to be taught from young.
Yundu yala the naobori laiko.
Yundu yala the naobori mubaba.
We just said hello, my name is Laiko and Millie.
We really enjoy the program because we get to
learn our own language
and show other people that don't know how to
speak Google.
And then now when we go out on the street, we can actually talk to our elders.
Big River. Hudson, nice one. Wawubajinga. So you say, not Negu. Remember, Negu is mine. I own it. You don't own the creek. So you say, Ngayu.
If you talk to our community tells us for our Indigenous kids to be whole, then they need their language, their culture, and their land. So a lot of that, you know, has been taken away from our Indigenous people. So we wanted to bring some of that back.